Where the magic's made.
What'd you say?
Where the magic's made.
This is where the magic is made. Yes.
Yes. Is there a reason why they paint them all black?
Lowe's has a 2-for-1 sale on paint.
Oh, okay, cool. All right. Yeah, well, that makes sense.
Yeah. All right, welcome to Warehouse F. It was built in 1948. Like I said, 9 stories tall, holds about 20,000 barrels. We do have newer warehouses that are shorter. That's to accommodate fire codes and building safety. They're 7 stories tall, but they made those warehouses wider and longer, and they hold 58,800 barrels. We have 100 warehouses across the state of Kentucky. We have about 1 million barrels resting here in Claremont, Kentucky, with 41 warehouses. The next would be in Boston, Kentucky, has about 1.6 million barrels, and then the rest are in Frankfort, Kentucky.
There's a Boston in Kentucky.
Yeah, we have a Boston, we have Paris, Kentucky, Versailles. So, you know, we're going to head, well, they call Versailles, but I'm from here, so.
Okay.
We're going to head in here, have a few tall friends, just to keep your awareness. They were shorter back in the early 1900s. There is a fire suppressant that runs down the middle and branches, so once you get in, you're not in the clear. Don't hit your head. Okay. This is an elevator for our barrels. To take them up to the 2nd to 9th floor, it holds 4 barrels at a time. While we're walking over, if you look up, you can see up to the 9th floor. I think it's pretty. All right, welcome in.
Oh, it smells good.
All right, friends, welcome in. So like I said, we have about 20,000 barrels that we can hold here because we have some rigs out. This holds about 18,000. It is about a little over 2,000 per floor. Majority of this warehouse is Basil Hayden, about 57%. Over almost all of the barrels are from 2021 and 2020. We do have a few older barrels, like our oldest barrel here is from 1998, and is our 8th millionth barrel, milestone barrel over there. You guys will have time here in a little bit to walk around, but I have some fun stuff to do first. We're gonna start all the way back when we distill our alcohol. Well, before I do that, do you guys know what makes bourbon bourbon? There are five standards.
51%
corn, made in the USA.
In American barrels?
Oh. Well, not American barrels, but it's the first use of the barrel.
Oh, yes.
When we distill our white dog, it cannot be any higher than 160 proof. When you get to 190, that's vodka. So 160 or less, but to get that white dog into the barrel, it has to be 125 proof. So the highest proof that white dog will go in is 125. When we bottle it, cannot be bottled any more or any lower than 80 proof. So the lowest proof of bourbon is 80 proof, and bourbon in general has no additives. Hello friends, welcome in. We haven't done anything fun just yet, just me talking. So when barrels are made, all of these little planks are called staves. They come in various sizes, and it's like a jigsaw puzzle to get all of these staves to fit together. The barrel is built on the head of the barrel. I won't lift this up, it's 500 pounds. Literally 500 pounds. But they'll put the staves into a bottom ring. They'll steam those staves, use a chain to pull them into the next ring. They'll place the other rings on the barrel. And then there's one special specific stave, and that is the stave with the bung in it. The bung is how we dump the bourbon out of the barrel, but also how we put the white dog into the barrel. I know, it gets even better though, because the way we get our bung out is with our bung knocker. every stave, again, is wide enough to have the bung knocker hit. We're not going to wine bottle the bung out. We're hitting it. Do I have anyone feeling froggy today? No. Okay, so before you do this, there's no pressure. If you knock the bung into the barrel, we'll never get it out.
Okay.
No pressure.
No pressure. So there's more space here. I recommend trying from this side. You're gonna hit as hard as you can. It's gonna pop it. So if you have sensitive ears, go ahead.
And I just hit beside it?
Yeah.
Okay. And what's the?
You can hit literally anything.
As hard as I can?
Bomb. Except for the bomb, yeah.
Hard as I can.
Okay. As hard, as long as you have good aim.
We'll see.
And it comes out of the bomb.
Andrew, no, you're good. No, that's what you want. Good
Excellent.
Job. You didn't hit in the bung or into the barrel. A+. Okay, before I get to the fun stuff, we're gonna reverse. This is alcohol that goes into the barrel before the aging process. Today it is Nopcreek distillate, so it's not yet been put into the barrel, and we distill Nopcreek at 130, so it's not yet been proofed down to 125 to go into the barrel. If you are interested in feeling froggy, you guys can try it. I saw that.
I'm sorry.
How to feed them first.
It, I'm sorry. Should be sorry.
Thank you.
Yeah.
You put your finger on it and then you give it a little sample?
Yeah.
Same theory.
So you just airlock it?
Huh? Airlock it, yes. Same thing. We're just in the bourbon world, so we're a little bit bougier. You're going to place your thumb here and you're going to fill my aria.
So I just pull it back out?
Yep.
And let go.
Yep, there you go. And let it completely drain. So sometimes whenever we do this, we might get char from the barrel into the sleeve.
It's still coming out, isn't it?
Yeah, get a little bit more. So go ahead and put it back in the barrel, let it fill up.
Okay.
Airlock it.
Is that right? Yeah.
Yep.
Not to the bottom.
There you go. Yeah, if we set it in the bottom, that would get the char in there.
Right.
So yeah, good job.
What's it called on the bottom?
The char.
Char.
So the char from the entire, we're not like, all the bourbon's gonna be the same in here. There's not like heads and tails like beer has. But the char, if this hits the wall of the barrel, it's gonna get the char in the tip of it.
Okay.
Wonderful job. So like I said, as this comes out of the barrel, it's gonna be 127 to 130 proof. You get that beautiful color from it, so it goes in that clear color, sits. If this were an older product, it would get darker and darker as it sat in the barrel, and that's all from the char. Whenever it's cold in Kentucky, this liquid is pooled and shrunk, and then as it gets hot, it expands into the barrel. So as it passes through every single time, it's pulling more and more flavor out, but also color as well. All right, now the...
Do you rotate the barrels ever?
We don't. No. So rotating the barrels, we want barrels to sit with a bung on top so it doesn't leak. But rotating the barrels means like taking it from the first to the ninth floor. The higher up in the warehouse you go, the hotter it gets. So we say those barrels age quicker. And then as you make your way down, the coolest floor is here. These barrels will also hold the temperature. So it takes about 3 to 4 months for them to go to the current temperature. So when it's really cold in the winter and we have a nice warm day in May, it'll take actually several weeks before it to warm up. And we want Kentucky's climate to cool it and heat it up, expand and contract it. That's why all of our warehouses have windows open year round. We want Kentucky's climate to do everything. So like even our floors are dirt floors, minus like what we're standing on right now, but underneath here is a dirt floor. And all the materials we use are wood. Wood will not affect the flavor of the bourbon, and that lets that temperature do what it needs to do. I'll pour this and I'll keep talking. All right, have your cup. And then if you guys want to make your way around to me. This is barrel strength. So whenever we dump this, Jim Beam is a large batch bourbon. We're going to blend together about 1,000 or so barrels. Sorry, I'm just going. My hands are just.
Yeah. I'll just take it.
Experience? Yeah. It's a very quick 30 minutes, that's for sure. To touch on the barrel thing, so we do sell single barrels. You have to go through a liquor store, and as he was saying, like, we will not give you that barrel by itself. So I know the mini barrels is what was mentioned. But we have to bottle it, and then we'll sell you the bottles, and you have to have an alcohol license and all that as well to get it. They're working on a, we're gonna go ahead and move this way just a little bit so she can leave. They're working on a full like beef your own experience where you'll go through sample barrels, pick your favorite, proof it down, and go home with six of your bottles that you bottled yourself as well. That's not up and running yet, and you're definitely paying for it.
You know, they do that.
I think it starts over $1,000 is the
They do that at Jack Daniels.
Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, but like you said, they won't sell you the actual barrel. They'll just bottle whatever barrel you pick and then ship it to you.
And then, of course, you can find... So did you get to take your barrel home?
I will.
It's empty?
Yeah.
Okay. Will they take... So say you bring your bachelor and your bachelor group and you bring as many people as you can and you still have like leftover bourbon in the barrel, will they just keep that themselves and give you the rest of the barrel?
They'll let me come back and pick it up. They can only sell me six at a time, so if I come back the next day...
A slow process, but that makes sense. Yeah. Nice. All right. Well, thank you guys.
Thank you.
This is where I leave you now.
That was cool.
Thank you.